I'm like that.
Yeah. Oh, this is a different reaction. I'm not crying.
No, that's good.
No, I did with my dad.
No, that's good.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, this is very, goofy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You saw it.
Yeah, I forgot.
Yeah? I dreamt I held you in my arms. When I awoke, tear, I was mistaken. So I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
What I've been living for. Please be seated. Who gives this woman to be married today? Friends and family of Mina and Jung, welcome and thank you for being here on this beautiful hot summer day. We are gathered together to celebrate the very special love between Mina and Jung by joining them in marriage. This is an opportunity for us to share not only in the joy of Mina and Jung's love, but also to reaffirm and appreciate the love and the friendship we experience in our own lives. The marriage of a woman and a man, I'm convinced, is viewed by God as an occasion of great joy, since it marks the beginning of a relationship that is second only to our personal relationship with the Lord Himself. Let us acknowledge that and seek His blessing as we bow our heads before Him in a prayer. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful and joyous day. Thank you for your light that has entered Mina and Jung's life. Thank you for all the miracles and blessings which you pour upon Mina and Jung. I pray that you continue to guide and protect their future lives. Please bless their marriage. Help bride and groom find the perfect place in this world for their love to flourish. Let the radiant light of their love shine on all around their friends and family. May all their future children be blessed. Lord, bless them with the inner gift of trust, compassion, forgiveness, and truth, that they may live and grow together in love and peace. I pray in your name. Amen. I just want to say a few words in Korean first. 안녕하세요. 오늘 이렇게 우리 정균 군과 미나 양의 결혼식에 오신 것을 정말 감사하고 또 환영하는 바입니다. 제가 정균 군의 삼촌으로 오늘 이 결혼식 순서를 도우는 일을 맡게 되었는데 참 기쁘게 생각합니다. 오늘 신랑 우리 정균 군은 한국에서 태어나 3일 된 갓난아기 때부터 오늘 35살이 이르기까지 제가 늘 지켜보면서 우리 정규이가 누구랑 결혼할까 늘 궁금해했었는데 약혼녀라고 어느 날 이 미나를 소개했는데 제가 만나고 보면서 참 이 둘이 잘 만났다. 말로 설명 안 해도 둘이 앞으로의 생애를 서로 만들어가기에 적합하고 가장 좋은 부가 될 것을 믿어 의심치 않습니다. 하나님께서 이 두 젊은이를 맺어주시고 오늘 이 특별한 결혼식을 할 때 우리 부모님, 친지, 또 친구 여러분 함께 축복, 축하 많이 해주시고 많은 사랑으로 격려해 주시면 감사하겠습니다. 오늘의 주인공은 이 두 새 신랑 신부이기 때문에 한국말보다 제가 영어로 진행하는 바임을 이해해 주시기 바랍니다. As an uncle to Jung, I've known him since he was 3 days old in Korea. Till today, I've always wondering who he's going to marry. When Jung first introduced Mina as his fiancée, I had no doubt that Jung found himself a gem, a pearl, a perfect partner, a woman who he will marry. The way you guys talk to each other and plan things to each other, I've seen doing some stuff together. I'm very convinced you guys have found yourself a perfect match each other. Today, I'm extremely happy for you guys and be part of this wedding ceremony. Based on my 2 decades of marriage, I've prepared a few words for you guys. I'm not a pastor, I'm not a professional officiant, but I hope you guys empty your mind right now and just think about this special moment for you guys. You have made a decision to be together the rest of your life together. That is not an easy decision for a lot of people these days. But I tell you what, you guys just made the best decision you ever made in your lifetime. Jung, you believe in God, right?
Yes.
God has chosen and ordained the man as a spiritual head and as a responsible provider in a human relationship. By God's plan, your strength, I mean, your financially, emotionally, physically, your strength must be your wife, Mina's protection. And your character must be Mina's pride. And you must live the Mina. You must live that Mina will find in you haven for which her heart truly desires. And Mina, it is God's plan that you be a loving wife, that you respond to husband's love and tenderness with a deep sense of understanding. Sometime your husband will act like a little child. Through a great faith in Christ who brought you guys together today, it is God's desire that you have an inner beauty that never fades, an eternal youth that is found in holding fast that things never age. As an expression that your hearts are bound together in love, Jung and Mina, I ask you to hold your hand together for me. Get a little closer. Okay, good. Jung, the woman whom you hold by the hand is to be your wife. She has offered you one of the most sacred things under heaven, a woman's life, a woman's love. And you may bring her joy or cause her deep sadness. But it is not what you bring in a material way that will make true happiness. Riches without love are nothing. It is only as you love her unconditionally and cherish her completely that you will keep her heart warm to yours. Jung, do you vow here in front of everybody here that you will love her, be true and loyal to her, patient in sickness, comforting in sorrow, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Mina? The man whose hand you hold is to be your husband. Upon your life, your love, your devotion, he will lean for your strength and inspiration. He will look to for your encouragement and cheerfulness and for confidence. No matter what others may think, they may forget John, lose confidence in him, and turn their back on him. But you must not. May your life and love be the inspiration that will constantly lead him to greater dependence on the Lord. Mina, do you vow in front of all these people that you will be loyal in adversity, ministering to him in affliction, comforting him in a sadness, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Mina and Jung, I hope you guys realize that nothing is easier than just saying words and making promises. But nothing is harder than living them day by day. What you promise today must be lived tomorrow and all the tomorrows that follow thereafter. And do not expect perfection from each other. And do not minimize each other's weaknesses. But always be swift to praise and magnify each other's strength. And see each other through kind and patient eyes. May God remain the central figure in your relationship. May you never take each other's love for granted. And it is my sincere prayer that when you come to the end of life journey, that you love each other more than you do even today. I've met an 85-year-old couple. Actually, they are one of my patients who are about to celebrate their 65 years wedding anniversary. 65 years of wedding anniversary next month. I asked them, what's the secret of your long, successful marriage? What bonds you guys together for a long time? To me, that looks so beautiful, each other. I see their smiles in their face. They're making jokes each other. As they celebrate 65 years of wedding anniversary, they said, the true love is not just the feeling you feel. It is all about respect and trust each other and being responsible for each other for life. Now, may I have the ring that John will present to Mina from his best man? John, this ring represents the covenant you are entering into today. You will notice that it is fashioned in the form of a complete circle without beginning or end, symbolizing the completeness of your love for each other. Do you, John, take Mina to be your wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death?
I do.
Now, may I have a ring that me and I will present? Mina, this ring is made of pure and precious metal. It will not tarnish or turn with age. It is a symbolic of purity of the love with which you are joined together today. Do you, Mina, take John to be your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death?
I do.
Throughout this ceremony, Mina and John have vowed in our presence to be loyal and loving toward each other. They have formalized the existence of the bond between them with the words spoken and with the giving and receiving rings. Therefore, it is my pleasure to now pronounce them husband and wife. No longer simply partners and best friends, you have become husband and wife and can now seal the agreement with that kiss. Today, your kiss is a promise. You may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, please all rise. And now, to all their friends and family who have come to celebrate this marriage, I would like to present, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jong Kyun Kim. Thank you.
stay on my
starting a Korean tradition called Paebaek. It's the bowing to the husband's parents. Okay, so Mina and Jung will be performing that with the assistance from Mrs. Choi. We'll be starting. Right now. Their bow. Now it's a tea ceremony and Jung's pouring.
Moby 되면서 좀 더 열심히 살렸구나. 고맙다.
Mina, 아들 딸 많이 낳고 행복하게 잘 살아.
Now they're going to do a traditional receiving. The parents are going to be tossing the jujubes and chestnuts. It's jujube is considered, because it has a seed, it's a boy, and the chestnut is considered a girl. So whatever they receive is... Mina wants a lot. So they have two chestnuts and two jujubes. Thank you. 정군의 이모님. 네. 혼자 하시네. 네.
둘씩 아들 둘, 딸 둘 낳고 행복하게 잘 살아.
정's uncle and aunt.
미나야, 아들, 딸 구별하지 말고 많이 많이 낳아라. 응?
축하해. 행복하게 지기마. 오케이. 이렇게 되고. 오케이. 정균아, 미나야 축하해. 그리고 아들, 딸 많이 낳고 행복하게 열심히 살아. 그래.
그러니까 정's family just wants you guys to fertilize a lot. Okay? So abundance of kids is all they want, okay?
John, congratulations. We finally made it. And I'm going to go with the same theme. When are the grandchildren coming?
Minan Zhang, congratulations. I wish you both all the happiness in your life together.
Take three girls, three boys, that's even.
He can handle it. Gonna change. Oh, hold on. So you guys, okay. Now the fun part comes. They get to have a drink. Token of their love. So Mina pours the drink to her husband. Now the husband pours the drink to the wife. Jujube. You're going to eat the jujube together, and whoever gets the seed is the dominant person. So, chew! Did you get the seed, Mina? And to carry his wife for life. For life! Let's get a big applause! Woo!
Thank you. Help me welcome the bride's parents, Elvis and Kay Les Chicano. The groom's parents, Mr. Kim and Mrs. Kim. Hannah and Jason. Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what? And Christine and Tree. Vicky and Jeremy. All right, now everybody please stand up and make some noise. Everybody make some noise, guys. The moment we all been waiting for has become. And let's all welcome our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Kim, Mina and John.
This is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves. And everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you.
Would you come and put it down on me?
I just want to talk a little bit about Mina and Jung. First, when Mina was first conceived, we couldn't tell on the sonogram. I guess back then you can tell, you know, if it's a boy or a girl or all this other stuff. So we couldn't tell. So normally the room you paint blue, sometimes pink. We painted green. Green was not the greatest color that we had, but we did it. And we assembled the baby crib, the little changing table and everything. And we would just imagine her when she was a baby, just being there and coming to us. Even as newly, or I guess we're first parents or whatever you want to call us. When you have your first child, we went to this place where they said, oh, if you're a first parent, you gotta have this buggy. It looked like from the 1950s Untouchables buggy that you pushed around. It had a chair. The chair converted into a desk. The desk converted into a buggy, converted into a high chair. So I was like, there's no way any of these mamas with these umbrella trailers are going to get in my way when I push my daughter around and everything else. So even then, she was a little spoiled, right? Just a little. Her grandparents put an inflatable pool in the middle of the living room. Why? Because they were afraid it was too cold outside. And the water couldn't be cold. It had to be room temperature or warm. Then they installed a swing inside the middle of the living room. And I got to test it out first because obviously the first grandchild couldn't fall. It was okay if I fell, but she couldn't fall. She also had a special wall. The special wall was where she would draw and paint and color. And when they went to paint the house, they said, no, wait. This is my granddaughter's art. So we're going to wait till later on, when she gets a little older, and then cover it up. And so as parents, is that close enough? All right. As parents, you get to see your children grow up, and you start experiencing them and seeing them, like, you know, you get to all the mannerisms that you kind of have, or Kay kind of has, So obviously she got her looks from Kay. And there, and I've been told I was a little OCD, not much. So her organizational skills came from me. I have actually an itinerary that she handed out to everybody that was in a wedding party. Everybody in the wedding party also got a sheet of paper with pictures on it of who everybody was in the wedding party, just in case I didn't know who they were in there. So, and I'm probably running a little late, so I got to speed it up, right? So then she talked to us, you know, when she first met Jung. Jung came over to our house. And when we first met him, I think it was a Friday or a Saturday. So my brothers were over. They came over. We were up grilling in the pool. Jung brought Kay a flower. It was an orchid, right? And brought me a bottle of Johnny Walker Blue. I was like, not only is he smart, but he's got great taste in there. So as many of you know, Jung is a very hard worker. But maybe you don't know, he's an accomplished golfer too. He went out golfing with us, and he's like, I've only gone to the driving range a few times, but I think this is my first or second time out in the field. Of course, every shot he hits, straight down the fairway. And every shot Joe and I hit, if it went down the straight down the fairway, it was a miss hit. Because we play our slice, hooks, fades, draw, shoe wedge. You know, we eventually get it there. In there. So before, oh, hang on. I'm like way down here. It's almost done. Don't worry. So, and one of the things that really impressed me about Jung was when Mina and Jung first wanted to get married or asked to get married, he actually came and asked for Mina's hand in marriage to me. I mean, that's a lost art, guys. You young guys, if you're not married, ask the father, you know? He might say no, yes, you know, flip a coin. And there, so, now before I go, there's a few things that we want to give you, a little bit of wisdom, and there, because we've been together for 37 years, and there, so, the first thing I want to tell you is, hang on, I got to go, I think I'm a little too far off. Hang on, it's 30 slides, I'm sorry. And there is always, hang on, always respect each other and never go to bed angry. You can argue, you can agree to disagree, but never, ever go to bed angry. That's the first thing. And love each other as you are now and not as you wish to be. Your life together is an adventure. Enjoy it. And remember, marriage is not the destination, but only part of the journey in your life. And finally, it's okay to have babies soon. And there's a, in closing, if I could ask you all to raise your glass, and I'd like to give a toast to Mina. She's a gift from God, and I will always be grateful to have been given the honor of being her father. May God continue to bless her and Jung and grant them safety, love, happiness, all of the days of their lives. We love you. Salud.
Hey, this is working. So I'll try not to mumble. I'm a mumbler. So when I first met Jung, I was on the porch of a house I was rebuilding. I was probably cursing in Spanish at some tattooed Salvadorians. And this guy who had a BMW pulled up and said, I want to look in there and see what you're doing in there. And I'm like, oh, this guy's pretty pushy. And so I let him in and we became friends. And over the years, I found out he is quite pushy. But his push did drive him to go to law school, build buildings, you know, while running, you know, dry cleaning stores at the same time. And it has really brought him great success, and it will bring him great success as a husband and hopefully as a father shortly, so his kids can hang out with my kids. And his push also has brought him to having quite a few big ideas, whether it be, you know, starting new businesses or buying sports cars that are far too expensive or trips to Miami, whatever it may be. He's a big idea sort of guy, and he will definitely make it interesting for Mina. And when I first met Mina, I immediately said to Jung, yeah, go for that. Do that. I was being a little bit pushy. But, and then, you know, after getting to know her for a bit, I said, Mina, when I first met you, I told Jung to go for you. So, you know, because your friend's future wife, you should get brownie points. And having gotten to know her, she's a really wonderful girl. She's a really classy, beautiful girl. And I think she'll be really great, except for her choice in pets. Not so sure about the dog. But I also have found out that she is also quite pushy. So she's a good match for Jung, and that they will definitely have a wonderful future together. They're beautiful people. And here's to Jung and Mina.
Cheers.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you to each and every one of the friends and family members gathered here today from all parts of the country, and those who have worked tirelessly to help create this beautiful day as we celebrate the union of Mina and Jung. Everyone, please raise a glass and share a toast to Mina and Jung's parents for bringing these two beautiful newlyweds into our lives. Cheers.
Cheers.
Woo! So I am Mina's maid of honor.
And I am Mina's matron of honor. Christine and I have known Mina for 20 years. And we are her oldest childhood best friends. We stayed in touch all throughout K-12. And in middle school, I didn't even take band class with them, but you would see me in there anyways. In high school, we begged our counselors to change our lunch period just so we could have the same period together. And although college and life has driven us apart, we still find a way to keep our friendship alive. We are three very different amigas of different sizes and personalities. You may not know this, but Mina has changed so much over the years as we grew up together. Mina used to be very shy and sweet, but now she is a fierce and strong-willed woman. Although she can be blunt at times, Mina knows what she wants, and the way she goes about it is very smart. You always state her argument first, and that's how she won over this lawyer. However, Mina also has a softer side, where she is very kind, thoughtful, and always considerate of others. She will always be there for you and has a great sense of knowing when to reach out or what to say when you're feeling down, while also teasing you in a good way to keep you uplifted.
One of the things I love most about Mina is her ability to maintain friendships no matter the time and distance, and to pick up right where we left off, which is made even more possible with the wonderful age of technology we live in today. So when Vicky and I first heard about Jung through Mina's text saying, "I'm going on a date. If I don't text you back, I'm missing," I was naturally very concerned, as any girlfriend would be, that this random stranger through the Coffee Meets Bagel dating app could be a catfish, a creeper, or something worse. However, once we were introduced to Jung and saw how happy Mina was, our concern quickly disappeared and was replaced with excitement.
The progression of Team Jung. So the progression of Team Jung has always shown through his generosity and actions. Jung is the type of man that has an abundance of prosperity, being great at many things, and while always staying humble. We were impressed with how Jung consistently took Mina out on many foodie adventures, like Chico, where they had their first date, or how he showed us he could keep up in tennis without boasting or talking smack, sharing his massage chair with all of Mina's friends while she invited them over so they could be extra comfortable. I see what you did there, Jung. But even more impressive was Jung's sense of reasonability, not being afraid to stand his ground and helping to be a balancing anchor for Mina.
Jung, we've grown to embrace and appreciate you because you really are Mina's better half. You put up with her in ways that we can't, and you complement each other so beautifully. We hope that as you embark on this new chapter together, you continue to uplift and support each other and be each other's biggest advocates. So without further ado, everyone, let's raise a glass in honor of Mina and Jung. Here's to the new husband and here's to the new wife. May they remain lovers for all of life. May your troubles be less, your blessings be more, and nothing but happiness come through your door. We wish you both all the love, health, laughter, and happily ever after. Cheers! Whoa.
I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you.
Everybody make some noise!